Welcome back to the channel of I hope you're doing absolutely well. Today we're back with another video. So today it's gonna be the review of the OSMP ROM based on Android 9.05 for the Redmi Note 3. So without any further ado, let's now get started. So here's my Redmi Note 3 running the OSMP ROM. So guys, this is a pretty new ROM which is recently launched for our Redmi Note 3. So let me show you the about device section before talking about anything else. So going into the about phone and the Android version. As you can see, here is the Android version. It's Android 9.0 and the version of this ROM, it says stable 3.3. The security patch is as expected, September 5, 2019. And again, as you can see, the kernel here is, I think so, this is Xcrema kernel, I'm not sure. It's written in Chinese here. As you can see, A2Z X28 version is 3.10.108. Most probably it's Xcrema itself. That's why the performance and battery life is pretty much similar to other Xcrema ROMs. I'll be talking about performance and battery life in the later part, so do watch this video until the end. So going back and talking about other stuff like the build date, as you can see, build date is specifically mentioned over here. It was built on Friday, September 13, 2019, and today is Friday, September 20th. Yes, I'm pretty late to review this ROM. That's because I had lots of other works, so I was really busy for that. So talking about other stuff like the digital well-being, as you can see, and the animations are of Android 10, as you can see, pretty much standard stuff. And the digital well-being graph is shown properly over here. I haven't updated anything yet from the Play Store, but it's working absolutely well. Talking about fingerprint scanner, for me it's working well, as you can see, pretty good. And the performance of fingerprint is also good, but not as great as MIUI as expected. Location also works fine. And talking about other stuff like the customization options, let me show you the OSMP customizations. As you can see, pretty much all the standard customizations are over here, and there is nothing new in this ROM when we compare it with this and other ROMs. Yep, everything is pretty much similar, like the status bar. As you can see, you can enable network traffic monitor from here. Also the clock settings. Talking about buttons, you can customize your hardware keys. You can also remap your hardware keys from here. You can also enable on-screen navigation buttons like this. As you can see, there are two launches, by the way. Again, the standard stuff. So going into customizations, let me disable navigation bar because I like using hardware keys. And all of these are pretty much similar to other ROMs, as I told you earlier. Again, the power menu is also here. Advanced G-Start comes pre-enabled. I didn't enable that. Like this. As you can see, you can directly reboot recovery, bootloader, soft reboot, or you can also reboot your system UI. So these are some of the customizations. For more, you can check my other ROM reviews where I have reviewed like most of the customization options. Talking about Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, everything seems to work absolutely well till now. I didn't have any issues with Wi-Fi, Bluetooth or anything like that. So talking about the performance in this ROM, let me show you my AnTuTu score first, then the Geekbench. And AnTuTu score, what I have got here is, as you can see, 1,01,423. That's really nice score. It's, I think, 4K lesser than the recent ROM which I reviewed on this channel. But yep, the performance is really good in this ROM. I didn't have any issues using this ROM. Data usage is really great. I didn't have any major lags in the system. Not even minor lags were there. Hiccups here and there sometimes, but which are not noticeable, by the way. Talking about the PUBG performance, guys, I didn't record any video for PUBG. That's because the performance is not at all good. Frame drops everywhere, lag, and yep, you just cannot play PUBG properly in this ROM. Even on the lowest graphic setting, it was lagging a little bit. That's why I just didn't wanted to record the same video again. It was pretty much similar to other ROMs. So when I compare this ROM and Evolution X ROM, Evolution X ROM has slight edge over PUBG gameplay. Not slight, you can say like at least 30% more efficient, and performance was really good in terms of PUBG gameplay in Evolution X ROM. And in this ROM, it's not that great. In a nutshell, the gameplay was not the best. It was lagging everywhere, frame drops, etc. So talking about the Geekbench results. Okay, I don't want calendar right now. Going into the Geekbench, here it is. And the history. Yep, as you can see, the multi-core score is 3511 and the single core score is 1450. That's really nice score in my opinion, and as I told about the performance, it is the same again. It was really good. So talking about the battery life till now, let me show you my battery states till now. So going into the battery, not the display, again display option also pretty much similar, nothing new over there. So talking about the battery usage. As you can see, when I first booted it on, the device was somewhere around 90% of charge. And for the first time here, even PUBG is not appearing. I don't know for what. And YouTube, it says use for 41 minutes and 2%, literally impossible, guys. I used YouTube for almost around 1 hour and there the battery drain was something around 8%. Later, I played PUBG. I just played one match, guys, Tedium, and there the battery drain was just 3%. I just couldn't play further. That's why I just went out of the game. Later on, I ran AnTuTu and Geekbench. I also used a couple of small applications which are there in the system, like the recorder, etc. Let me show you that. As you can see, recorder app is here. You can also screen record and sound record. That's cool. And now the battery is down to 70%. Battery life seems to be really good in this ROM, and it is pretty much similar to other ROMs which comes with the Xcrema X28 kernel. There is nothing new over here. And as I told you, the PUBG performance, I don't know why is it not showing up properly here, but in the digital well-being it is showing up correct. As you can see, even the smallest application used is been shown over here. Here it is, YouTube, AnTuTu, PUBG, Geekbench settings and others. Others means I think so the recorder itself. This is really nice because you will get to know your usage correctly, at least over here. So in a nutshell, the battery life in this ROM is pretty much similar to other ROMs. Nothing like extraordinary when in terms of battery life, but it's really good. And talking about the applications, as you can see, here are a couple of standard applications that comes with this ROM. I didn't install many applications here except PUBG, YouTube, Geekbench, AnTuTu. All other apps came pre-installed, and the camera app is here. As you can see, again, this is the Snapdragon camera app. And here are the settings. Most of the thing works absolutely well, as you can see. The shutter speed is again similar to other ROMs which comes with the Snapdragon camera. Horrible shutter speed, as you can see. Slowest of all, I should say. Let me just take a picture really quick. Quality seems to be okay, but the shutter speed is really horrible, guys. Even the video recording should work absolutely well. Here it is. Camera app is stable, but guys, the shutter speed just sucks. So if you wanna use the camera app, just download the mod version of Google Camera app. That should work well. So this was a quick little review of the AOS MP ROM running on the Redmi Note 3. So that's pretty much it for this video, guys. If you liked it, please give it a big thumbs up and do subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Also, do follow me on Instagram and Facebook. I'm active over there. You can ask me any questions regarding tech. This is all about technology 24/7. Signing off for the moment. You guys have a great day. Peace.